sitting up straight, breathing. Inhale, center. Exhale. And come to center, ear to shoulder.
He seen one egg yesterday and wants me to eat more. Sounds sick.
Yeah. Come to center, other way. Come to center, ear to shoulder. Coming up, switch your legs. Circles. Distractions. Coming up. And reach. Deep breath, stretch. Coming up. Other side. Down and twist. Come to center, other side. In. Deep breath. I am reaching behind me. Open through the chest, open through the back. And coming forward, looking down. Feet forward, toes to the sky, deep breath. And coming up and around. Now this foot can be inside if that's happier. It's up to you where you like it. Center, other side. And open wide. Okay. Exhale, twist to one side. Make sure those hips stay on the floor. And come into center, other side. Coming into center, feet together, hands on those knees. And coming onto your stomach. I don't know if I'm going to need that or not, but it's here. Oh yeah, I want my arms out. So forehead, right arm, left leg, lift. The other two press into the floor. Breathe. And coming down, switch sides. And breathe. And pressing back in the child's pose. And down dog. Back down through child's. And turn to your back. One knee comes in. One leg hangs, it's about an inch above the floor. If you want to point your nose towards your knee, you can. If you'd rather just leave it on the floor, that's fine. Breathe. And leg to the floor, hands behind the thigh. Come in, gentle stretch. And that hand, same hand on same leg, coming out to the side. Make sure that other hip stays connected to the floor. That's the hard part here. And come center, switch its sides. It only goes so far, you can feel all of that. And into that twist, you can let that leg go. You can also bend that knee and look towards the camera. Hi, guys. Breathe. So control. Inhale to center. Other side. So you can put the nose to the knee or head to the floor. Other foot out. Breathe. The other leg hangs. And the leg comes to the floor. Gently stretch the top leg. Breathe. Keeping this up on the floor, leg out to the side. Deep breath. And switch hands, coming the other way. Again, we're keeping both hips on the floor. And you find where that stopping spot is. And coming through to the twist. Again, knee can be bent or straight, looking away. And slowly coming back up. Feet wide, knees to the side. One over your head. You can bring that ankle to your knee on the inside if you want. You don't have to. And coming in, other side. Again, ankle can go to the knee or it can stay. Other arm up, breathe. And coming in, and circles. Switch directions. And one ankle to one knee, that foot can be on the floor, anywhere in between. I like to move, maybe you like to stick. And wherever that wants to be, other side. And knees to one side, head looks away. You can have a lot of space. That's useful. You can use that blanket or you can come all the way to the floor. Head to center, then the legs. And we go to one side. You don't have to come all the way down. You can come to a blanket or the floor, looking away from your legs. Head to center, legs to center, slow, controlled to the floor. And that spot underneath your back, exhale, just let it touch the floor, inhale, release. We got about five of those. And favorite relaxation pose. I'm in pigeon toes at the moment. My hands are close to my body where they're comfy. My heels are wider than my toes and my knees are touching. Breathe. I know some people like to be flat on the floor, but I remember a time when my back wouldn't do it. And that's where I had to be. So if you're not comfortable there, you can be on your side, you can sit, you can do whatever you like. The important part is to be where you can release the tension. So we breathe. Thanks for joining me again, guys. Have a good weekend, and I'll see you again soon.